Oh, okay. Crash, jump the gap.
All right, let's try this.
DC 15 acrobatics.
I put an equals sign in there by accident. 1d20 plus 6. Wait, I want to use
D4?
my dex save is awesome. I get plus 6, so as long as I get a 4 or higher, I'll be fine.
Okay. So roll to catch yourself.
Whew.
You catch yourself and you pull yourself back up.
Awesome.
Off that ledge. Sit back off that ledge, my friend. All right.
Nice.
And so copyright claim now. That's
a good question
Patchy has. Does the pixie use regular size tools or pixie size tools?
It'd probably be a mix of each, because she's making regular size weapons, so she has to like use a regular size grip. But I mean, there's probably some fine tooling weapons, because these will be have the insignia of the guild on them that she probably is able to get at her size. So they're extra detailed. Plus, since she can cast magic, that's how they get the magic property to them. Okay.
If anything I need on my hammer, it's details.
Exactly.
And the ogre needs large weapons, so she also has large weapons. I mean, large.
No, that'll be normal, but I mean, just takes extra work. Okay, so Torgo, you're in the lead. This is getting to be a rather long chase. You have to push on. And as such, you can use your best save to endure 1d6 non-lethal damage. So what is your best save?
I guess wisdom or charisma?
So you're using your own force of personality to push yourself on.
It's pure strength of will.
Exactly. There you go.
I'm talking myself up. I'm my own hype man.
You can do this. You're leading the pack.
And then I can't apply athletics or insight or anything like that.
Nope. This one is just a straight saving throw.
But remember which ones you get bonus saving throws on, though, too.
Mm. You apply your proficiency to... what is it for? I think it's charisma and will for paladin. Strength and charisma. So you can add your proficiency bonus to, if you choose, charisma.
Which is what he chose.
Okay.
So I would do plus 5.
3 plus your... What's your charisma modifier?
15, so 2.
2, yes. 3 plus 2 would be plus 5.
And can I use my inspiration?
Yes, you can use your inspiration. You'll no longer have it. And you can roll 2 and keep 1.
Okay. So roll d20.
Mm-hmm. K1. Plus 5.
K1 plus 5.
All right, I got my inspiration right here.
Dang.
Oh, no. Ooh. All right. Roll me a 1d6. You do succeed and move on, but you are, you know, a little bit winded from this.
You stub your toe.
Literally, I stubbed my toe.
I'm not seeing the 3d dice. That's weird.
I think because this is so wide, some of them are going back off at the beginning.
My dice doesn't, it stays in position when I move the mouse.
Because I see the d20, but I don't see the...
Oh, weird.
I see the Crash's last d20, at least. Probably bug from their updates.
Thanks, roll 20.
There's a 6. I see that one.
There's mine.
I don't know. But yeah, I don't always see all the dice either.
Weird. Okay. So, anyway, you take 1 point of damage, Torgo.
Non-lethal at that.
Yeah, non-lethal.
Whew.
If you take non-lethal damage equal to your hit points, or if it ever equals to your remaining hit points, you go unconscious but aren't at risk of dying.
They take another 64 of those.
Do a couple laughs.
Stub all 64 toes, Torgo.
Death by paper cut.
It's not even death, it's like pass out the paper cut.
Alternatively, stub one toe on a Nintendo 64.
Oh no.
Right. Ooh, that does sound dangerous. Those things are built to last.
Mac, I believe you were going to auto-pass it?
Yep.
Boom. Bam.
And then right. Ellie's up there.
Ellie. Did I say she was going to auto-pass it? Well, just you. Oh, yes, she had the smell.
So you got the auto-pass, and I got the auto-pass by following her.
All right, I'll allow it. Next. Hello, Ellie. Suzu.
Well, since Maven and I are hanging out now, I'm going to use my third bardic inspiration on her and say, we can do it. We can do it. And then I will roll. Oh,
wait, sing it. You have to
we
sing
sure
it.
Can. We sure we can, Suzu.
Put your back
exactly,
into it.
Exactly, we sure
it.
Can. And I will roll insight. Oh, no. I'm actually going to use my inspiration that I put on myself. Oh,
there you go.
Thank goodness.
All right, Traxio, where are you at? Right here. Yep. So you move forward. Had an easy go last time. Would you like to use your survival skill to track him down or insight to figure out where you might have gone?
I'm going to use my insight because I have no survival skills. And I'm going to use my inspiration for the roll. How do I do that?
Inspiration is a yes or no status, whether you have it or not. So
I have one
from
yes.
So you have one.
It's the first one we got in the game. I have never used it.
So then you'll use that one up. You'll no longer have one. And then you roll 2d20, keeping one, K1, plus your wisdom modifier, because insight is wisdom based.
Plus 4.
There you go.
God damn it, I would have made it with both.
Well, the good thing is you can't get another inspiration.
Yeah.
Cut out at the end of that one, Crash.
But yeah, you can.
Yeah, we got inspiration. All right, Maven, your turn. Survival or insight?
I bet he's still not back yet.
He's rolling.
Oh, talk.
I don't hear him.
Oh, add the
1d6. Fail.
Oh, yeah. I'd have to hit like 4 plus.
It's worth it. Try.
And I guess I can.
You can do it.
What's
you
the
can
worst
do it?
That can
just
happen?
My regular inspiration.
There we go. Hey!
You're using your survival, so yeah.
Is he still on a rooftop?
Suzu.
Pardon?
Is he still on the rooftops?
Yeah, he's still on the rooftops, okay. Yes.
No, he's just floating in the air.
No, maybe
like
he's
he
come
just
down.
Don't care.
Did get that critical jump, so.
He's now flying.
Damien.
Yeah?
It's your turn. You have to either use your insight to figure out where he went or survival to track him down.
Insight, final answer.
Okay, roll me an insight.
All right.
DC 16.
Wait, 16? It says DC 11. Oh, wait, no, I'm looking at the wrong thing, I guess. Mm-hmm. Wait, where's...
We are... Where the
oh, I missed. Okay, cool.
We're on the pause.
The bear tracks. Because you're tracking him down.
He's a bear, apparently.
Nice, human. You know that.
Damn it, can I use my inspiration?
You'd have to declare it beforehand.
Well, it's before I guess I automatically find out if I passed or failed.
A 6 not gonna help you beat a 16.
No, inspiration is advantage. Mac, you're thinking of the wrong thing.
Oh, sorry.
You know what? Since this is really the first time we're using advantage, I'll let you roll a second dice. But in the future, guys, declare you want to use it beforehand. Most of you are. I'm going to be lenient because it's
just like me. Fuck right
me.
Before.
All right, and you no longer have your inspiration. Card.
Don't have guidance.
Oh well.
It's plus 4.
Oh wait. So if I what would I have to roll on the guidance?
It's a 1d4.
You'd have to roll a 5.
Take the chance.
No, he's got 11. He's rolling survival, isn't he?
He said insight.
Oh.
Oh, never mind.
You'd have to roll a 5 on that d4.
Just save it.
I could do that.
Now we're wrapping around because you can only use like 70 squares on this.
Shit, we should have stayed at the first bit. We would have gone instant.
That's true.
Yeah. We went in a circle the whole time.
I troll us. We're all back at the car.
He's taking more things.
To follow.
Oh my god, it's pigeons!
Oh my god, it's pigeons!
Torgo, I know what you're thinking of.
I know exactly.
Oh no. In order to get past all these damn pigeons, you can make a animal handling check of DC 10, an acrobatics check of DC 10, you know, to tiptoe past them. However, if you fail, you will take 1d3 points of damage, and if you fail by rolling a natural 5 or lower on the dice, and then you'll automatically move past, because the pigeons will attack you. What would you like to do?
Well, I don't have proficiency in acrobatics or animal handling, so it doesn't really matter, does it?
Animal handling is wisdom-based, acrobatics is dexterity-based.
Oh, I'm going to make some KFC today.
That's what I was thinking that. Do the wisdom one, I think. Oh, no, you're both 14, too. Never mind.
So if I go with animal handling, do I still get a modifier?
Yeah, your wisdom, your base wisdom modifier.
So plus 2.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Not being proficient in a skill means you don't add your proficiency bonus. And you make it through the pigeons.
Got them.
It's like, shoo, shoo. Go away, scary Excellent. Bird. Because these are like, I don't know, up to your knees.
They're halfling-sized pigeons.
Yeah, you're a halfling, and these are regular-sized pigeons.
Well, let's say, actually, as a halfling, I should be able to get a free pass because I'm small and quiet.
You should be able to take one as a mount.
This is a comparison to a lot of birds.
Actually, he should have a harder time because the birds can just eat him.
Yeah, really.
No, tame one as a mount.
Oh my god.
The mount has to be larger than you in order for you to ride it. That's why, as a medium creature, you can't ride Ellie. Alright, who we got next? William of the Maze!
Alright, so Ellie's here at the pigeons. Leave her verse.
Yep. She's way back at the gosh darn pigeons.
So, I'm just gonna throw this out there. He's a goddamn panther, and these are pigeons.
That's true.
I'm thinking they would, if she charges in there, they're just gonna fly away.
Matt cut out.
You cut out.
Yeah. Can she roll intimidation?
Like, she should be able to just charge in there and scare them all away.
Cut out again.
Holy fuck.
Yeah, no, I heard him. She should be able to go in and scare. What's its charisma? What are the stats? Here we go.
Or whatever, no. She'll just eat them all, I don't care.
Yeah, really. We'll use an attack roll to bypass this. So, d20 plus 4,
right.
And on a DC 10.
Basically, that means she kills one and the rest fly away? That seems like a good justifies. Them.
Yeah, I would think those birds would fuck right off if one just suddenly got head of, was stuck in a panther's mouth.
Yeah.
Yeah, but they still go back because it's where they eat and get their bread. So they kind of like fly away to disperse around her. And then as she runs by, they fly back.
Those are some stupid damn pigeons.
God damn it, birds.
Do you not, are you not around pigeons very often, Mac?
They move out of the way.
Yeah.
They don't come back, as soon as you go.
They go back.
Right, but they wouldn't get in my way either.
They don't get out of the way of my goddamn car when I drive home. I have to honk the horn for them to fucking...
Really?
Really?
Yeah.
That's... Did you run them
birds
down?
By you suck. Birds by me are way...
Yeah.
You actually stop and honk your horn instead of just driving through them?
Yeah.
I slow down.
Wow.
Well, that's why they don't move, because you slow down.
Yeah, really.
Exactly. I just gun it.
They'll move.
All right, William of the Maze, push on with your best saving throw.
And if they don't, they'll die, because I'm not stopping. Right.
Pretty much.
So that would be my strength, which is plus 7.
Ooh.
Plus 4, plus 3, yeah.
So DC 20 with a plus 7.
Aw, oh, fuck you.
All right, roll me a 1d6.
No, I use my inspiration from Not my inspiration, but my bard thing.
Ah. The bardic one? Ah.
Bardic inspiration. All right, roll me a... Roll higher than a one.
Yay, did it.
That's actually lower than a one.
All the way back over here. Bam. Okay. Pac made it, Ellie made it. Suzu!
Alrighty, I gotta give myself the pep talk. Suzu, we gotta get those tools so we can get a sweet-ass looking whip. You gotta do this. So I will make a charisma save.
Okay.
So that is plus six. God damn it. Too bad it doesn't make it any less tiring. And then a 1d6 for damage.
Yep, for non-lethal damage.
Oh, it's really tiring. It's fine. I could pop my second wind, couldn't I?
Yep, you can heal yourself by 1d10 plus 1.
Yeah, I'll just give myself a second wind. It's all better. Nah, Suzu's fine. She is back to full health.
Yay! Push on, Suzu!
Is that a first level healing spell?
It is a bonus action that fighters get at level 1.
Yep.
Oh, okay.
And they can only do it once per short rest.
Oh, all right.
All right, Traxiel.
Can I toast them with my fireball?
You're not there yet.
Slow down.
Can I toast anything else with my fireball?
Well, since you're trying to push yourself on,
you can toast yourself with a fireball.
Motivate yourself. If you don't do this, you get a fireball.
Oh my god, yeah, DC 20, great. I'm going to persuade myself.
If I don't do this, I'm going to fireball myself.
One D20 plus 7. I'm going to intimidate myself. I don't know.
No, it's just a base saving throw. You only add a stat modifier.
All right.
Or the proficiency, so, if it's the one that's got the dot.
Yeah, or the proficiency. Oh, yeah, which you do, because you've got a charisma. You're proficient in charisma saves. Because sorcerer.
All right, I can just do that then, I guess. So, 1d20 plus 7.
Yep.
And I probably still won't make
it. Yes. Running hard, guys. Roll me a 1d6 for some non-lethal damage against yourself.
Fuck, leg cramp. Where do I get the shit rolls now?
Now you get good rolls when you're hurting yourself.
5.
You got a leg cramp. I eat more potassium.
There's gonna be some toasted birds in the
All right, Maven. Your best save, I think, is Will.
Passed.
Oh, nailed it.
Jesus.
Can I go ahead and tackle the pigeons as well?
Tackle them?
On your turn, I guess. I gotta move all these things.
Man, Morgor would make a mess of those pigeons.
Yeah.
Pigeon paste.
All right, Damien, you're falling behind. You still got to pick up this trail.
Just send us a postcard. We'll get back.
Did we just yell at him? Hey, over here.
Yeah, I was about to say there's like 5-6 trails now that are in the same direction. Can I use perception at least to see the trails?
Yeah, so sure. You can use your perception instead. It'd still be a DC 16.
Yeah, but I get a plus 9 now.
Go for it.
Fuck yeah.
Yeah!
I would have gotten it anyway.
It's like, oh, hey, they're over there.
We're like waving and jumping.
I still can't see them.
All right, Tyrone.
Fuck,
you're leading the pack.
Okay, what's next? Bring it on.
You're on the ground. As you're running through, trying to encounter this really pushy beggar. He's like, alms for the poor, sir. Alms, please, I'm hungry.
And I want to fireball him too.
And he won't get out of your way. Now you can intimidate him. Not persuasion. It has to be intimidate. To, you know, get him to back off. Or you can give him 1 gold.
I'm going to give him 10 gold.
Wow. That's very gracious.
Can you tell him to get out of the way for the rest of us too then?
No, beggars don't work that way. They forget immediately.
Do I see this? Do I see him giving up 10?
No.
No, we're trapped behind pigeons.
Aren't I theoretically on the roof still?
Yes, you are. There's pigeons everywhere, man. There's fucking pigeons. All right.
Ellie's not
William of the maze. Ellie is not, correct.
I'm pretty sure Ellie can just get past a beggar. He's a cat.
Yeah, he's not gonna push a cat.
Hey, cat, give me some.
Cat, can I have some money?
Desperate.
All right.
Okay. He's like, oh, I forgot my wallet. Sorry. Where am I gonna
put it? Is it too late to set pigeons as my favorite enemy?
Yes, it is. And that would be
easy. Can you even do that?
All right, William of the May. Maze. You have an S in your name down on the top.
Well, I'm sorry. I put that like a
call
week
lightning
ago.
Time.
6 weeks right. ago.
So, would you like to use your except handle animal or acrobatics?
Probably handle animals, I guess. Yeah, I have a proficiency sure in that.
That's what I thought. Roll me a handle animal. Don't roll a 5.
So plus 3, plus 4. It's plus 4, actually.
Okay. Hoping for a 1.
I'm the person to do it.
I know, right?
You rolled another 20.
You're an evil DM.
Oh, a little bit.
All right, I kick one on my way through.
Wow. Aren't you a ranger?
I'm a ranger that's about exploiting nature for personal gain.
Kind of is. I mean, it's not like he's a druid.
Isn't that kind of the idea of every ranger?
Roll me a 1d3, Mac, just to see how much damage you do to these things.
Do I get a plus strength bonus?
Yeah, 1d3 plus your strength, because it's an unarmed attack.
Wait, why didn't it right there?
Wow, pigeon got fucked up.
Yeah, that... the pigeon went flying without the aid of his wings?
Yeah, so... Team Me has killed 2 pigeons. Step it up, people.
Don't worry, there's a fireball coming if you
want me to call lightning.
No, don't call lightning.
You're in the middle of a town, dude.
Yeah,
that might be a bad idea.
You know what? I'm already behind. Maybe I'll just coat them all in oil and set them up.
Oh my god, please no.
Suzu.
By the time you're there, they're not going to be there anymore.
There's a bunch of pigeons in front of you.
Hey, Lo, can I just like use prestidigitation to just like throw sparks at them so they fuck off?
Ooh, that's a good one.
Just scarecrow them.
They barely got phased by a giant panther eating one.
That one.
What's that?
Roll me a casting stat to see if it's successful or not. It'll still be a DC 10, but you'll get to use your casting stat.
Which is 8. A cantrip.
Yeah. It's still. How successful is it? It's a pass. So you do scare the pigeons out of your way.
Yeah. Go away, birdies. We have better things to do.
It's not really an immediate threat, so after you pass by, they go back.
Yeah, I just spooked them a little.
A little bit.
Just like, hey, check out these fireworks, you dumb birds.
Did you kick one on the way by?
No, I did not kick one on the way by. I probably pet one on the way, actually. I probably said, hey, what a good audience, and just pet one.
Yeah, I'll be here all week.
What a terrific audience.
Yeah.
You know what, roll me, we'll go 1d20, and if it's above 10, somebody saw that and they were impressed.
Yo. No, no one liked my sparks.
No one was impressed that day.
Can I still be impressed?
I liked your sparks.
Thank you.
I didn't see it. I'm ahead of you.
Traxio.
Can I toast them or can I not toast?
Oh, you totally can. Roll me a casting check.
I also like not to hurt any of the pigeons.
If Zayu petted one, he should have to roll a save versus rabies.
It was just my charisma, right? Or is it the proficiency?
It's 8 plus your proficiency plus your casting.
8?
Yeah.
1d8?
Yeah.
Oh, what?
No, it's 1d20.
All right, plus.
Oh, no, my bad. Yeah. No, that's only for save. Yeah, go for it. 1d20 plus your casting stat plus your proficiency.
Alright, so
7. Yo, look, should my charisma bonus have been added to my 8?
Did you roll?
It's just the
to see if someone was impressed.
There's gonna be some chicken tonight, peoples.
Yeah, what's your charisma bonus?
Plus 3.
Oh, there's gonna be some super chicken!
Wow.
Wow, okay, you nuked all of the all of the pigeons?
Do I remove my spell slot for this one of them?
Wow, yes. my hatred for Traxial is just growing and growing.
This I just ego is the one that's on the rooftop. That's
sure we can't PvP?
Aren't you in two different places, though? Like, you're up on the rooftops. And
no, I would still see
it.
My question now is, how many food rations do I get from this?
I'm thinking Ellie might need to turn around to pick up some.
Stop? Yeah.
God damn it, I have to stop to pick him up.
Yeah.
Ellie might be distracted by all the charred bird remains.
Yo, does the beggar run after the cooked birds?
He should!
He can pick those up later, it's fine. Nobody's gonna pick up some charred chickens. All right, but that's going to actually pass it for everyone else. The birds on the rooftop have flown away permanently.
I knew KFC was good.
So there's auto-moved.
Where are we at now?
I'm at Pigeon still, but you said it auto-passes me, right?
Yep. You're auto-passed.
And now it's my turn, so I get to go on the disintegrate.
Oh, shit, what did I do?
I think it still uses your turn to auto-pass.
Yeah, it still uses your turn to move through.
What? That's what happened to me, Matt.
You just don't fail.
You don't have to roll.
You're given a free success.
I wouldn't have failed anyway. It was a DC 10.
You can use an action to do something else, like another guidance you have.
Pick up a charred chicken.
That's up to you.
You could guide me to roast some more chickens.
Can I cast Moonbeam on Traxial? I'll use my third level. That's 3d10 plus 4 right there.
For what, sorry?
You said I could, right?
You can use a spell, yeah, for free, but I mean, no PvP.
Oh.
Because, I mean... Nice. No PvP, yeah. So, but you can use, like, a guidance if you still have a guidance.
If I use guidance, all I have is resistance, and I don't think there's any... Like, that's for magic saves, right?
I don't think so. Resistance. You touch one willing creature. Once before the spell ends, the target can roll a d4 and add the number to one saving throw of its choice. So you've encountered saving throws. There is a saving throw ahead, and since we're doing all skill checks, I'll even allow it for skill checks this time around. So it'll act kind of like a guidance.
Okay. Crash, you still have my guidance I gave you, don't you?
Yep. Okay. Haven't used it yet.
I'll cast resistance on Suzu.
You casted what on me?
Resistance, which we're pretty much using as guidance. Yeah.
Oh, okay, cool.
So.
Thank you.
Okay. Now it is Damien's turn. Damien, you're still kind of lacking behind, but you have to push on to catch up.
He should not lose HP for failing them.
Ace that one.
That was a dex save, by the way.
Yes. I knew that one. It's obvious that your best stat is dex.
I think if he would have failed that one, he shouldn't have taken any damage because he could have just eaten chicken on the next stop.
If I know anything, it's eating a chicken fully restores your health.
Just grab a chicken on the way and just eat it on the run. That's healthy.
Whatever, it's right, so... microwave, basically.
Well, they were purified by flame anyway.
Well, the parasites are dead.
Yep, really. All right, so... Up ahead is a bridge.
You have to set it on fire too.
It's made out of stone, as you can clearly see.
If I try hard enough.
I'd like to use my stone check on it.
However, unfortunately, there's a broken fruit cart blocking the way past the bridge. It's very narrow. In order to get past this broken fruit cart, you have to make either an acrobatics check of DC 10, an athletics check of 12, so, you know, hurdle yourself over, climb sort of thing, or stealth of 13.
So it doesn't see you?
Wait.
Well, stealth is like being nimble.
Isn't that what acrobatics is?
Plus
wouldn't that be... Okay, whatever.
Yeah, whatever.
It's a little harder.
Seems redundant, I guess.
It's a little bit, but it's another option.
You seem redundant.
Thank you.
However, just with the pigeons or the jumping the gap, if you roll a natural 5 or lower, you're going to take 1d6 damage because you fall as you're trying to climb past the cart, and your clothing will be covered in fruit stains.
That's going to piss me off.
What if you succeed and get a natural 5?
Then you... Yeah, that actually dawned on me earlier. You'll still take the damage, but you still pass through, I guess.
You don't do it very gracefully, I guess.
Yeah, you'll take half damage, we'll say.
I don't want no damn fruit stains.
Yo, so I got it. Prestidigitation, yo. It cleans stains.
Oh, I also got some Orky Clean.
Hey!
Let's not do the Orky Clean. Let's do the prestidigitation instead.
So, as a halfling, can I just scurry under the cart for free?
You're really milking that.
The cart's a little bit lower, plus there is an animal pulling the cart. So I'll give you advantage on getting
limbo.
You'd advantage
on athletics. Mm-hmm. Athletics is what, strength?
Yes.
So that'll be my proficiency in athletics plus my strength modifier?
Yep, and 2d20, because I'm giving you advantage on this one.
2d20, keep one, plus six.
Hey, Matt.
Actually, this one actually doesn't even say if fail. It's just if a natural 5 or lower.
Check the stream. You're blocking Logan's avatar.
Got him.
Yeah, okay.
It's not like they're missing something anyways, because the
camera's blocking it.
What?
Not working. Oh, the turn order's in the way. Gotcha.
Yeah.
I have so many screens in a weird way, it's hard to tell which is from which window.
I know, right? William of the Maze!
Alright. Well, I'll do the cat since he's further ahead.
Okay.
Yeah, she'll just run and jump over it or something.
Panther has something like plus 6 stealth? Yeah. And plus 4? Yeah, plus 6
stealth. Can she just climb over it?
That would be an acrobatics or an athletics, basically. That's that's how the skill transcribes.
Okay. Bounce on the cart.
So which skill would you like to do? You do have a plus 6 in stealth.
Plus 6 in stealth for a 13. But acrobatics is a 10 with plus... Plus 2 from dex.
Yeah.
I guess she'll try and stealth past it. So does she get the dex and the 6? Or just the 6?
The 6. That's included in the stat bonus.
Yeah.
For easy math.
Ooh.
But she doesn't take damage.
Nope. So she kind of slowed down.
She does that thing where the cat goes to jump and then bails on it.
Oh my god, she biffed it.
And then she starts licking her foot. It's fine. No one noticed.
I did it on purpose.
Yeah, that's what cats do. It's fine.
It is.
She barks. Woof.
All right. William of the May. Which one's
hey,
right there?
Hey, Joy. It's still got my webcam. I'm all the eye candy you need.
Matt,
you're approached by this beggar. He's really in the way.
Ask him, have you ever heard the virtues of OxyClean?
Oh my god.
Hey, well, let's see.
Yeah, what about it? I'm not gonna move for
you can make. You think of all the windows you can squeegee.
He's heard of it, but he can't afford that sort of thing.
You gotta spend
some money so he can buy some.
You gotta spend money to make money. You could wash windows and triple your investment.
Oh, this is great and all, but he has no money, sir.
He's got at least 10.
Could you spare some gold?
He's got at least 10 gold.
You don't know that.
Taking an awful long time.
I read once that beggars on like the streets of Montreal, actually hell, in my home city, make like
I'm guessing he's got more money than he's letting on.
Beggars are,
yeah, exactly.
Beggars.
So yeah, I'm trying to push the sale. Like, look, I know you're doing pretty well out here. I've seen beggars. I know what's going on. You want to make real money, though. Do this. Give you a discount. Only 40.
It costs you 25. You sell it for 25, dude.
No, it's... Oh, sorry. I keep thinking... All right. 22. Give me a discount.
Nope.
Oh, what? Why was he get advantage? Bullshit.
Because he's acting poor.
Whatever. Give him a gold and move on.
All right. Take one gold off of your character sheet.
Yeah, one gold's really going to put a dent.
Cheap bastard.
I know, right?
I tried to sell him something.
Make money off a fucking bagel.
Dude, that is bad.
I'd say it's within my character.
And you get angry at me for toasting some fucking pigeons.
Yeah, really. Luckily, you didn't notice I killed two.
The beggars go, oh my gosh, it's the great popular Suzu. Could you be so kind and generous and spare a gold?
Offer him an autograph.
Actually, I'm going to go ahead and cast friends and persuade him to let me and my drow friend behind me just go ahead and pass. Unfortunately, I don't have time right now.
Friend?
Yep, it is advantage on any charisma skills that aren't towards creatures that aren't hostile towards me.
What if he secretly is hostile because he hates your music?
You gonna help the person that just torched all those pigeons?
Tell him to go pick up the pigeons.
We gotta chase after a thief.
If he wants to open up a death metal band, he has to be open towards torching pigeons.
It's true.
It's important part of baby metal.
It's true.
No, but if he wants fucking fire, if it's baby metal, he doesn't get fire.
Well, no, yeah, death metal you kill goats, baby metal you kill pigeons.
Eh.
No, baby metal you don't kill anything.
But then you don't need my fire because they don't need fire.
No, we just
baby metal. You kill people's hopes and dreams.
Yes. No. No. It's the opposite.
Give me your Ellie.
So is that good, Logue?
Yeah.
Okay.
There you go, Joel.
Roll me a casting. Well, first you have to roll me a casting. This will basically be him saving against it. But
I don't think it has a saving throw.
Yeah, but you're still trying to get past a... oh man, I should have lost the page.
He's making your roll. Fuck you, that's why.
Yeah. This is about skill challenges. Let's see. I will check, though, if it does have a roll.
I want it to roll persuasion and just have advantage on it.
That does seem...
Oh, okay.
Does that make sense?
Let's see. For the duration, you have advantage on all charisma checks directed at one creature of your choice that isn't hostile towards you. When the spell ends, the creature realizes that you used magic to influence its moves and becomes hostile towards you.
That's duration fine.
Duration up to 1 minute. Creature might seek retribution in other ways, depending on the nature of your interaction with it. I'm gonna allow it.
Alrighty.
That'll bring up something interesting later.
Alrighty, Mr. Beggar, let me in my draw.
You're gonna get a stalker.
Yep, that's
nailed it.
Pass. So you're through. All right.
And I did specify to let my draw friend pass, so Deluxe should get through for free as well.
Yep. Deluxe, you're through.
The beggar's still there.
The beggar's still there, but he's not going
to
bother you.
I'm going to look at it and say, if you wouldn't have let me pass that, I would have turned you into fried chicken, too.
Oh, my goodness.
He's like, yeah, I've had worse.
In before beggar is final boss. He was a lich all along.
Okay, he's a mimic.
He wants free access to one of the concerts, and that's where he gets toasted. On accident.
Maven.
Since I'm just
you're now descending to the ground, yes.
Yeah, since I'm just descending down the building, I'll just use spider climb and auto pass it.
You know what? That makes sense.
That makes sense.
Okay, cool.
Goddamn Spider-Man.
All right.
Spider-Man.
That's it, I guess, for me.
Yep.
So.
Damien, the pigeons flew away. Auto pass.
Sweet deal. And then I'll auto pass the next one, too.
No, you have to just... Oh, yeah, because you got the climbing.
Yeah, what's up?
Aren't you lucky?
You're also Spider-Man. Too many Spider-Men.
He gets two free checks because everything got fucking smoked.
That is the virtue of being the slowest.
It is. Right, this one I was already in, but I picked the picture purely for Zayu.
Yo, what?
No. Oh, no.
Torgo, oh no! Child. There's an innocent blind child stumbling in the middle of the road!
You might want to watch out, because Deluxe might kill it.
I'm going to toast something else today.
You have to make a DC check to dodge the child. However, if you fail, you'll collide with the child. Oh, you no. personally will take 1d6 damage. The little girl will take 1d3 damage.
What?
And since it's a child, the child has only 5 hit points.
Also, be wary, because before Traxio kills the little girl, William of the Maze is going to try to sell it to
Crow. And I'm going to take whatever I sold to the child and sell it for myself.
Look, I might have to be disposing of an innocent girl's body here because you're clumsy.
Crash will steal it.
Is 5 HP the max HP?
Yes, that's the max HP that the child has in the current HP.
I don't know if there's much you can do, because I think the idea here is we don't know the child's there, right? It's Dutt's, like, last-minute dodge.
I'm just looking if there's any way I can either buff her on the way through or move her out of the way, or...
Yeah, you can move her out of the way, but, I mean, you're a stranger. You'd have to make a charisma check.
Yeah. Yo, I'm gonna give her a bardic inspiration to give her a saving throw.
Not your turn.
I know.
Yeah, I'll do the charisma saving throw.
Okay. So that was going to be a little bit harder. We'll say it's DC 13 seems fair. I mean, she's blind, you're a complete stranger, but I mean, clearly you're approaching her. It's like, look out, there's something in the way, and oh, you're child size yourself. So
1d20, so plus
your charisma.
Just
and I guess persuasion too.
So plus 6.
How much does a little child weigh? What, 60 pounds?
Not much, like 40.
God, throw her.
All right. So you use your turn. You don't progress, but this is no longer a challenge for anyone else. The child is in a safe spot right now.
Yay, good guy, Torgo. Good.
I was possibly going to throw her.
I was possibly going to put her to sleep in the middle of the
street. I just said a quick question. In my turn, will my spider climb allow me just to climb over the thing?
No, because it's like difficult terrain sort of thing.
Damn, okay, because I was going to go real quick because I got family coming over.
No, okay. We are nearing the end.
Make the family roll a d20. If they fail, then you fail. All
right, William of the Maze and Ellie.
Yeah, so just trying to get by this.
Yeah, you're both there. So who are you rolling for first?
Ellie's the stealth. What was it, plus 4? 6.
6.
Yay!
Yep, Ellie makes it through.
All right, so athletics is strength.
Mm-hmm.
So I get plus 4, but I don't get the proficiency bonus.
Correct.
All right, I'll just do athletics then.
Bam.
How much does the cart weigh?
A lot. It's full of fruit.
It's a
bit. Deadlift the cart.
Yeah, I'm pretty strong. I just lift it and throw it off the edge.
Like 500 pounds, maybe?
How much can I weigh? Lift?
So like 15 times what your strength is?
Which is what? What's 15 times 18?
I don't know, a lot.
That's a lot.
That's like 270.
Yeah.
15 times 18, that's it?
Yeah.
You ran the calculator. I don't trust you.
Susie, in the meantime.
Wait.
I will do acrobatics.
Okay.
So that is, what is my acrobatics? It's like super
high.
Oh
shit.
Yeah, I'm about to like ninja flip over this bitch.
Go for it. Sorry, everybody coming in from Bagel, that most of the webcams aren't working. That's Roll 20's fault. I can't fix that. I'm going to say it's their fault.
Kind of sort of is. All right.
Normally there's webcams here.
Traxial, where the hell are you? Right there?
I'm at the bottom of the list.
Yep. Traxial.
Toast the car. No.
And thank you very much, Bagel, for coming by for some Dungeons and Dragons.
I guess there's nothing else to do but just go for the check, huh?
Yeah, acrobatics, athletics, or stealth.
Didn't I have, like, a stealth bonus for being a drow, or was that only a thing in, like, 3.5?
Yo, look, can I grab food on the way?
Because I thought we talked about that, but I don't have it.
Stealing, but sure.
No, I'm kidding. I don't want to steal it.
Between the pigeons and the fruit, we can make a nice meal.
Well, I didn't pick up the pigeons that I roasted.
Yeah, no, there's no proficiency in acrobatics for elves.
Not even stealth for being a drow or something?
Nope, no proficiency.
There's nothing for drow anyway, so probably not.
They used to be like a +3 level modifier, so level adjustment, so.
Alright, so I guess I'll just roll for acrobatics.
Okay.
That's a plus a dex modifier?
Yep.
Roll 1d20 +2.
And if you're proficient in it.
Nope, I'm not. I'm definitely not. Come on, please, acrobatics. Please.
Oh, someone's getting fruit.
Oh!
No, you're covered in fruit.
Not my clothes. Not my sweet dragon scales.
Yo, Traxiel, I got this. We can clean it up.
And take 1d6 damage.
Fuck me.
Because you fall and slip on some fruit.
God damn it. Fuck off!
The most dangerous enemy in Dungeons & Dragons, fruit.
I'm at 27 health now.
Oh no.
I did the math.
Fuck off.
This actually could have... If Deluxe had rolled and failed like everything and rolled max on damage, he could have died. But he's passed most of the damage.
Fucking fruit. Now. That's why I'm out of like a vegan. Fuck you, fruit.
Maven, your turn.
Karma for roasting those pigeons.
I pass.
Which was this
acrobatics,
one?
And I'm not proficient in it, so it's +2 because it's my dex modifier, and it's 10, right? So
yep, meets it, beats it. All right, Damien.
Game over. I mean, turn over.
Yep, automatic pass. Tyrone, you can now advance.
We're past the innocent blind girl.
You already said it. I have to reveal the next area.
Logan, can I just advance and skip my next turn?
Actually, you've already passed the girl. So it's an auto pass, and you're in the next area, which is there's no design here, but you've run and chased the enemy into a box corner.
We appear to have come across a void of nothingness.
Imagine this is like a box. He ran down an alley, but the alley is a dead end. You've trapped him in a dead end alley.
We ran for nothing. You've just been here regardless. Great.
You caught up to him, basically.
Yeah. All right, well, let's just slaughter this guy and call it a day.
All right, so Tyrone, you actually do have attack. Oh, I need to roll initiative for him.
So is it basically just regular combat rules at this point?
Yep, regular combat rules.
Let's see, my movement is 25, so I can't reach him yet. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
Is it? Oh, you would have been able to approach him.
Oh. Let's see, I'm going to use my... Am I able to use an intimidation on him?
Yeah, if you want to. I've actually accounted for this.
That would be a bonus action, right? Or would that count as my action?
That would count as your action.
You know what, let's try and just get him to surrender first, intimidation.
Okay. So it'll be an opposed check against his charisma. So you roll yours.
So RD20 plus...
He's getting the acid.
6.
Ain't nobody steal from William of the May.
Would it be 5 or 6?
Your intimidation is charisma, plus you're proficient in it, so your proficiency bonus, plus the 1d20. Charisma modifier, plus proficiency modifier, plus 1d20.
Okay.
Wait.
Ooh.
Are we doing the kid? Because didn't the kid move out of the way?
The kid was moved out of the way. Another, that's another free pass. For everyone.
Orgo's fighting the guy who stole our stuff already.
Oh, okay.
So this is opposed to him. Now I'm using the stat block for gladiators, and the gladiators have the trait of brave. The gladiator has advantage on saving throws against being frightened. He is not intimidated.
Oh, very well.
What the fuck was that?
Cats? I don't know.
I was making a noise at my cat for making a noise.
So it is. I'm gonna try to send this.
And I will not use
so my rough being action. Picked up, I know.
Okay. All right, so he gets, it's his turn in the order. He gets to attack.
Ellie.
22, that's a hit. So he attacks you with his spear. He whips out a spear and a shield.
Clearly a sword on the graphic.
I don't know, looks like a really short spear to me. The damage on that is...
Isn't that the definition of a sword?
Isn't a short spear worse than a sword, actually?
Yeah, it's just like a sword, but without sharp edges.
There we go.
He's wielding a toothpick.
Did I do that right? No, I did not.
1d2 that you... That, you're rolling dices of dice.
I am.
Like, you got diceception going on there. I don't know what that means.
There we go. It's 2d6 plus 4. There we go.
With a one-handed weapon, he does 2d6 plus 4.
He is a brute. Melee weapon deals one extra die of its damage when the gladiator hits with it.
Uh-huh.
And I negate three of that damage, right?
Correct. So you only take 6 damage.
6 damage. So it puts me at 58 health.
Guy seems implausibly powerful for a guy who's stealing tools out of a cart.
Stat blocks. I held up the stat blocks to the screen.
Remember, that's not working.
Well, you guys can see it. Okay, so he also has multi-attack. No, that's not it.
What's he also has an attack helicopter.
You know that one? There we go. That is a miss. 14. However, he gets 3 melee attacks.
Now it sounds like you're pulling things out of your ass.
No.
Actually, he gets 4 melee attacks.
No, he gets 3. And he misses with the next 2. All right, so that's his turn.
Actually, he gets 7 melee attacks.
Ellie and Mac succeed.
Yay.
Suzu, you succeed.
Yay.
Waiting for Crash to use assassinate on the blind innocent child.
She'll always be surprised, so I'll always be able to assassinate.
Traxiel, your turn.
Fuck me. I'm going to probably take more fruit stain. All right. I'm going to take the fruit cone, like the fruit gauntlet 2.0 here, and I'm just going to try it again.
Okay, so acrobatics was it?
Yes. God fucking damn it, more fruit!
More fruit stains! Roll 1d6.
Final boss, fruit cart.
I'm just sitting here watching you try and climb up the fruit. Like,
just falling all over it. Oh. Maven, where are you?
Can't hold all these limes.
Maven just progresses, innocent blind child.
Yep. Damien! You run up and you see Traxiel just falling all over a fruit stand. Fruit's going everywhere, it smells.
So I have an idea. Can I use my core hook and like throw it here to like go across the bridge on the bottom, like swing across.
I'll allow it, but if you fuck up, you're fucked.
That seems way more dangerous than fruit.
Do it.
Won't get fruit stains. That's the important bit.
No, instead you'll be in whatever the hell's in the river.
Okay, you know what?
Do you know what they do with rivers in medieval times?
Logan, what would the DC be?
Oh, God, this would be kind of hard.
Okay, screw it.
I'd say probably 13, and but allow you to use your dex.
I as well just do stealth.
Do you have advantage on climbing? No, it's not a climb. I let you have your advantage, because cores, they have advantage with their rope, don't they?
Sure.
Is there something special about them with it?
Yeah, core hook, I think, is a finesse weapon.
Oh, that's what it is. All right.
Whatever. You know what? No, this is what my character would do. I'm going to do it. I'm going to do the shit out of this.
Okay, so the dex and add your proficiency modifier with it.
Okay, so that's basically the same thing I would have done before, except the DC is higher.
A little bit, but you get awesome points. You'll get an inspiration back if you do it.
Oh, I get to reroll that.
You do, but yeah, hope for another one.
Yes!
There you go.
Oh, boy.
All right, so...
By the way, on my turn?
You advanced automatically.
Okay.
You throw your grappling hat, you swing down low, you keep swinging up, and you land it, and you get your inspiration back.
Oh, hell yeah.
He gets his inspiration back, because it's cool.
I like to think the lucky thing is he dropped the rope, but then caught it again with his other hand or something.
Yeah, I just barely saved
Tyrone!
Himself.
Or like his foot gets caught in and it still swings him over.
Torgo. Your turn.
I think I'm just gonna smack him.
Okay.
I've been doing goofy rolls the whole time. Let's see. One. What is that? 1d20? Or is it? Do I do 2d20 now?
You get two attacks now.
No, it's two separate attacks. Oh, you didn't do your second attack last time, either.
I didn't attack last time.
Oh, right. That was your full action, right. So, yeah, it's two separate rolls. One attack, followed up by a second attack.
Okay. So, 1d20 plus my strength modifier.
Yep. Plus your proficiency modifier.
Oh, whoops. Well, I think that's probably... I'm assuming that's a pass.
That is a pass. And as you're swinging down, he goes to raise up his... Shield, where's his AC, damn it? Right there. He goes to raise up his shield to block it, but you are able to bypass it. And you make a solid hit, which is 1d8, I think, plus your strength, plus 2 for damage. Because you got that feat, or that fighting style.
Let's see. So plus 5.
11.
Nice.
Okay, and you had a second attack.
Now,
d20 plus, so it would actually be plus 5, wouldn't it?
The roll, yes. Or, no, plus 6. 3 for your proficiency, 3 for your strength.
Oh, that's probably not so good.
No, that is a miss.
Okay.
Now, I don't know much about our society, because we haven't really delved into that. Is anyone going to care we're hacking a guy to bits over stealing something out of the back of a cart?
I've worked with the town guard. They trust me.
So you can murder. Okay, good to know.
Torgo is licensed to kill.
He's got diplomatic immunity.
Hey, it works in Skyrim, you know? You do one thing and then suddenly the whole town guard is on you. And I tried to stop him. I tried to get him to surrender.
Oh, shit.
Oh, shit.
Just rolled a crit on you. And he is using a spear, which is a piercing weapon.
It'll be fine.
Yeah.
Achilles heel, normal damage, and 1d2 dex damage. Target speeds are reduced by half until healed.
Doesn't seem to be a huge issue for this fight.
Well, he could run away now.
He's got to disengage, though.
But he's cornered.
Yeah,
he could run past you. I mean, he'd still run into us, but he doesn't know we're there.
Torgo take 9 damage, because that's 12 reduced by 3.
Imagine we're in sight by now.
Maybe, I don't know.
Yep. And you take 2 dex damage. But I don't think you apply dex to your AC, so in the long and short of it, it doesn't really affect you.
Okay.
But sort of just remember the 2 dex damage.
And if we have to do more running, I guess your speed's halved.
I'll make a note of it.
Spoilers, I think this is the end of the mission, though.
Yep. Roll number 2.
Oh,
figures.
And now he cuts off his own heel.
Now he does more damage to himself than he did to Torgo.
It's quite possible. So, melee weapon. Critical mistake. The attack hits you and is a critical threat. You must roll to confirm the critical hit. In 5th edition, all criticals are confirmed. He does critical damage against himself.
Oh, shit.
He so literally does.
Double damage to himself.
Himself.
Don't forget those 2 dices.
Yep. So we times 2 this damage.
Oh, now he rolls crap.
18.
What weapon is he using for 2d6?
He's using a spear, but he's brutal because he's a gladiator, or he has a brutal trait, which deals an extra dice damage of whatever weapon he's using.
Fancy.
Can I get that?
Nope.
All right.
Not unless you become an NPC. And his 3rd attack.
Can Morgo get that? Morgor.
It's not in a stat block. 20. Does a 20 hit you, Torgo?
It does.
Okay.
Love that. He's got the gumption to keep attacking after impaling himself.
Yeah, really, eh?
I like that word, gumption.
11 minus 3 is 8 damage.
How you doing, Torgo?
I'm at 41 hit points.
All right.
Mac, William and Ellie arrive on the scene.
And I got healing spells lined up if I need to take a turn.
Yeah, that's what I was thinking. I got some too, but I'm gonna run in and join the fun.
Okay.
So
I was kind of hoping he'd be sitting in a bloody pool by the time you guys.
Yeah, it's all right. I'm here for what? 4 attacks.
This was completely justified.
Yep. 4 attacks.
All right. Can I just? All right.
You can roll 20. 4 times the d20 and then add up all the damage afterwards. Sure.
All right. 4d. No, that's. Anyway, I'll just do it 4 times. All right. Yeah.
Yep.
4d20 or no, 1d20 plus 7.
Your strength is
4 and proficiency is 3.
Yeah, it's 7.
Where's the dice thing? Gone.
The left.
Oh, there it is. It's back. So I can hit the reroll button. So 1 hit. Is that a hit?
He raises his shield and blocks that 1 hit. So no, it is not.
That's not a hit.
Mm-hmm.
That's probably not a hit.
Or that was is that? A hit.
It is a hit. So he's got a special thing on the first attack or something.
He has a reaction. Yes.
So I hit with 1 with an axe and I guess 1 with a hammer.
1.
Because it would be 1-2-1-2.
Correct. Yes.
6 plus 4.
Nice.
Good hit.
Yeah. It's another good hit.
Hey.
You don't steal from me.
Okay.
All right. Ellie's going to do her pounce charge.
Mm-hmm. And she'll end up in this square to the side.
She goes that way.
Yep. So plus 4 for her.
Whoa!
Wow. That's funny. I'm not even gonna bother with the roll. He's just prone. Oh no! How do we get prone? Let's go prone right there. Oh, that's so
small. And now he has arrows in his back.
What does it mean when you're prone?
You need an action to spend. You need to spend half your movement to stand back up.
Is that a crit?
And disadvantage on
and attacks. Yeah. And disadvantage on attacks. I think it's advantage with melee attacks against you.
Wait, what?
I think you also have advantage.
Oh, we have advantage.
Yes.
Yep.
Ah. Let
me set that up.
He has disadvantage on all attacks.
All right. So for a claw attack, is that a crit?
On the claw attack, yes, that is a crit. What the status?
All right. Well, let me know when you're done the crit card, so I can roll.
Crit card. All right. So, it's slashing four is her, right?
Yeah.
No, is it piercing?
No, it's claws slashing.
Slashing. Okay. So the critical on the slashing, wide open, normal damage, and target provokes attacks of opportunity from all threatening opponents.
Ooh.
Wow.
Ouch.
A little bit.
The cat just did some friggin' work.
So roll damage for Ellie's claws.
Okay. Then her bite.
Yeah, roll to hit for the bite.
Wait, no, you said the bite auto hits.
No, he auto falls down.
Yeah. But it's advantage, you said, because he's prone, right?
Yep.
And it's plus... What is it for her plus? Damn it.
Four.
Four.
It's four on both.
Keep one plus four. All right, that's going to be
a hit. That's a hit. Plus five
damage.
Don't
watch, you're too far away.
Torgo, you did an attack of opportunity.
But is it two attacks?
Yes, because it's one attack action.
But only by 40 feet.
And then I get four attacks.
Yes.
Oh my goodness.
He's trying to disengage, huh?
He's knocked down.
No, he's not trying to. The crit made him trigger this.
Can I try to get him to surrender again?
Sure. Gets the same advantage. I mean...
Just kill.
If Mac keeps attacking him, though...
Well, that's fine if Mac keeps attacking him. I don't care. My conscience is clean. So that's 1d20 plus... Do I do 2d20? Keep one. Yeah.
No.
If it's advantage? No.
No, you don't get an advantage on the skill check. Wait, what?
How did that work?
What do they keep? I forgot to keep one. Well, either way, it would be the 9, so 11. So you got a DC 11 with your intimidate check.
Boom!
Damn. All right, he surrenders. Mac, do you want to keep attacking him?
Do it.
Let him go.
Okay. So, Suzu shows up on the scene to a, well, it seems to be disabled enemy.
Seems like it's already over.
Unless you want to attack, do you want to attack him?
Heck no, I don't want to attack him. Although...
I kind of want to brand him with the mark of Orky Clean, though.
Sorry, what was that, Zion?
I think I will throw my net on him, though, and keep him trapped.
Okay, yeah, throw me... roll to hit on that one.
Let's Alrighty. See.
What's the...
Oh my god.
It might be it's a range. I know it's range. It's probably just range.
We decided that we had to be 5 feet for it.
Alright, well, you move in for that. That's fine.
Yeah.
Because that thing's heavy as hell.
Yeah.
Unwieldy.
Dude impales himself on a spear and mauled by a cat, and he's like lying in a pool of his own blood, and you still throw a net on him.
I want to trap him.
I want to use the net. I spent 100 gold on this.
I rolled a 16 on it.
All right, let's see. When you use an ash, and it's going to be a full action to use it, not reactions or anything like that. And he's not going to try and escape either, because he's already given up.
Alrighty.
Traxiel, you don't know any of this has happened. Rolly, you pass the fruit card.
I am, right?
Am I? It's my turn?
It's your turn, Draxiel.
Food cart time.
What's the distance? Like, is this distance the exact same to the guy, or?
He's gonna show up. No, it's not proportionate. It's like around a corner, so you don't even know this. You still have to get past it.
He's gonna show up covered in fruit, and we're gonna be gone.
You can just auto walk up to where I'm at, though, because that was cleared.
I want him to. I want him to roll to get past this.
I'm just going to wait.
It's gonna take a couple hours.
Fucking hell.
Well, no, go back to our car. Just go home.
Damn it.
He just gives up and goes home.
There you go. You made it through. Finally. Alright, so everybody catches up.
Am I around the corner now?
You all eventually get there.
Oh, right. I wanted to go.
Oh, well, you can go. You show up.
Movement turn. Right here. Passive, invoke flame blade.
Okay.
Attack.
No, Haven, what the hell are you doing?
Wait, but you already surrendered.
You do have advantage.
Haven, what the hell are you doing?
Seems very out of line with reactions
so
to other
that's
things.
What, 3d6?
Let's see. Flame bait is magic, isn't it? Well, I mean, some of it's actually.
Yeah, it's just 3d6. I don't think I get a modifier.
All right, magic. For some reason or another, he's also electrocuted. Magic is weird, man. Double damage. If electricity spell, target stun for 1d4 rounds. So it's not an electricity spell, it's a fire spell, but you still do double damage.
Is he dead?
No.
Fuck.
I randomly chose this guy, just based on the CR. So he has the appropriate amount of HP. So add that. How's he doing for HP though? Combat has been reinitiated. Damien, you just got past it. You swung past it.
Well, you said everyone's just caught up.
Yeah, everyone's caught up.
He doesn't get the fruit trial? Fuck off.
He swung past it, dude, and he got his inspiration back. He remember that
he did a worse
Tarzan?
Yeah.
Yeah, he did it harder. So you arrive and you see everybody's, you know, kind of ganged around this guy and he's under the metal net. And you just saw Maven, you know, take a slash at him.
Well, now I'm gonna spend my action talking. Hey guys, relax. He surrendered. We're good.
I agree.
I stopped. Didn't want to.
Well, I mean, I'm reacting to seeing Malice, so I'm assuming that everyone's still beating up on him.
Okay. Is that your turn?
Yeah, that's it. I'm not going to threaten anyone. I'm just going to say, hey, you know, stop that.
Understandable. Tyrone, what are you doing? You saw Maven rush in and attack.
Can I do a persuasion roll for him to stop attacking?
On him again?
Or
on Maven?
On Maven.
Okay. You can, but I mean, it's up to Maven if.
No one even told me that I was outside of this, so I didn't even know that the person gave up. So, as far as I'm concerned, we're still.
I mean, you
in
can
battle.
Talk it out even.
And this person messed with my group. So, and not to mention, okay. I'm still heated right now because of all the animal killing and everything. I'm pretty pissed off right now.
But he's under a metal net and not moving.
Doesn't matter.
Okay, fair enough.
I didn't know that we were done getting rid of him. As far as I'm concerned, like I have shit that I need to deal with.
Okay, fair enough. Well, he surrendered, and we don't need to kill him.
Okay.
No.
So, as a reaction, Maven, Digital, do you stand down?
No.
Okay. In which case, that means he will try and break free with a strength check. What did we rule the strength check was going to be since this is heavier?
Oh,
it was
Christ.
It defaults to 10.
I think you said like 15 or 18?
15 sounds fine. 1d20 plus, what's his strength modifier? 4.
So you guys, if you're gonna get me to stop attacking, you can't just be like, oh, he surrendered. You have to give me a reason why I should stop.
He
like,
surrendered.
Because he surrendered?
Yeah,
because
but he... like, that's just you being like, he surrendered. You should actually try to roleplay it instead of just being like,
what's
oh,
the roleplay? He surrendered.
He surrendered. Surrendered. You should stop.
That was yes. Torgo roleplaying.
That's about it. What, that's about what, how he
what,
rolls.
What benefit is there to him not being killed?
Not murder?
Not shedding any more needless blood.
You already said we could get away with it.
Yeah, there's no blood on our hands. And
go to jail.
Where did this guy even come from?
He's a random thug. And
well, I mean, we don't know
that. He stole from us and attacked us.
Yeah, but we're better than that. We're better than that.
Oh.
Look, here's what we're going to do. He surrendered, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to mark him with the symbol of OrkyClean in acid, and that'll be a good message to everyone not to mess with me.
So, Mac, you're hitting him with acid then?
No. I'm not hitting him with acid. When it's over, I'm saying I'm going to do that, first of all. I'm not doing it.
Are you actually saying this
yes.
in character?
I'm saying I'm going to do this. I'm going to mark him so everyone knows he's a thief. With my symbol, because branding.
Well, that's definitely aggressive.
Yeah, Jesus.
All right, so you're it is your turn now, Mac. He's tossed the metal. As his action, he tossed the metal rope off of him, and as his move action, he stood up. So it's now your turn in order. What would you like to do, Mac?
I'm not doing anything yet.
Okay, is Ellie going to do anything?
No, she's just kind of pacing around.
Alright,
Is he officially disengaged right now?
No, he's back in the fight. He's stood up. He's thrown the net.
Well, I'm gonna until he attacks again. I'm assuming he's hanging on.
God, I don't even know what to do, man.
Spear in hand.
I'm gonna cast Tosh's Hideous Laughter on him. I'm gonna give him the good old Ojo laugh.
Hideous Laughter. All right. So the saving throw is 8 plus your proficiency plus your casting stat. So
yep,
wisdom
six.
Save.
So
that's up to
14.
So he needs 14. All right, for a will save. 20 plus, what's his wisdom? Plus 1.
No!
He froze it off. What are you saying there, digital?
Well, I will,
private.
I mean, I'll take the opportunity attack. I'm just gonna get behind, Maven and just get ready to throw him away.
Okay. So
I ain't even gonna talk. I'm just gonna get behind him.
Okay. This is him right here below the cat.
Yep.
Okay.
Yeah, I said I was gonna take my opportunity.
Oh, you're moving.
Take his.
Attack of opportunity.
Yeah.
All right.
On me?
No, on me.
Yeah, because he's just he's moving around. Yeah.
Oh, okay.
That's a miss.
Yep. Do attacks of, I actually wonder if attacks of opportunity. I gave attacks of full attacks to the other two. So he gets his full multi attack on you as well.
Can you just use your action to disengage though?
I already used mine to cast a spell.
It's a reaction. Yeah.
Oh, right. You cast. I forgot you cast a spell. Sorry.
Yep. It's a move to. I need to look this up. Whether. Attacks of opportunity at the multi-attack. So that one definitely hits you.
Yeah, that one definitely hits.
Does 13 hit you?
13 does not. Not even close.
2d6 plus 4 damage. Minimum damage, 6 points.
Snake eyes.
Wow, what a chump.
You just, like, blocked it with your pecs.
Blocked it with my gigantic tits.
Why did you walk behind me?
What? Because I'm about to pull your ass off.
I don't think that's a good idea.
I'm going to do it
Maven,
anyway,
your turn. Dork.
So just so everybody knows, I have a reason for... I'm not going to say why, but I have a reason for wanting to kill this person.
Probably say that.
Yeah,
because we're all seeing you as evil now. You should probably tell us
she's
reason.
Racist.
I just did say... That's me talking to the party. I have a reason to kill this person.
Yeah, what's that reason?
No, I'm saying you should say what the reason is.
I shouldn't have to. You should know that if it's me, that...
She's being racist.
I wouldn't be that adamant about something unless there was a really good reason for it.
Well, my character doesn't really trust that after seeing you try and slaughter a guy that was surrendering.
I don't really know you well enough to take that on face value.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. No one's really going to take
that
on face value.
That is a miss.
Okay.
Damien.
I'm just kind of having a crisis of conscience over here because I don't want to kill him, but I also don't want to hurt anyone. So I'm just freaking out in the corner.
Good action. That's about what I'm doing.
Valid Damien. Action.
He's throwing a temper check.
Okay. Tyrone? He's still being attacked, so at this point, intimidation will fail.
Okay.
You need to resolve your party conflict. And then I'll allow a re-roll at that point. But at the current moment... So what would you like to do in the moment?
This is a tough call. Because at this point, in character, I don't feel like I have a reason to necessarily mistrust Maven.
Mm-hmm.
But I don't want to see, I don't necessarily want to shed any more blood needlessly.
Okay.
Torgo has a crisis of faith and doesn't do anything.
I need to
either.
Check grapple rules because I assume that's what Zayu's going to try and
that
do.
That is definitely what I'm going to do. Yeah.
I think it's just an opposing.
Yeah, I was wondering about non-lethal pounce attacks by Panther as well.
That'd just be a grapple check.
Okay. Or myself with 18 strength, I guess.
Hmm. Grapple check. A, B, C, D, E, F, G. Grapple.
I'm gonna ask Maven to explain himself. But I will not attack the guy.
Good, finally somebody.
Okay, as a reaction, you can reply to that, Maven.
So what's the deal, essentially?
As a child, my mother died. It was covered up as being accidental, but I know for a fact that it was murder. And I believe this person was one of the people that was responsible for it.
It was very coincidental.
Doesn't it make more sense to take him alive then? To question him about the other people?
Not for me, it doesn't. Questioning doesn't do any good for me.
Well, we could find out something.
My mother's already dead. It doesn't matter.
Well, if you're so hell-bent on revenge,
yeah, you can get
this guy wasn't alone. Like, I think there's more to it than just this guy, then.
In fact, they could have had an order from someone and we could figure out who the leader was. But if we kill him, we will never know.
I think peasant women are ordered to be killed that often. I don't think there's a big conspiracy on it.
Yeah. I know that this person was with one other. But I know what that person looks like. And I have an idea of who it is already. So I don't really need to know anything about anything further.
Then let local authorities take care of it.
Yeah, my character is standing behind. He should face justice, not death.
Says the rogue.
Yeah. Well, I'm going to pretend to play my character correctly from now on.
Rogues don't have to be evil.
I know, it's a joke.
I be honest, I don't need any opinions from the thief.
Is that an insult? My guy's a little offended.
Maven, come on, you're better than that. We don't need to kill this man.
You of all people should have my back.
And I do have your back. That's exactly why I'm saying.
You know the torture I went through with my non-biological father.
I know.
And the hell that I had to go through and endure because my mother was killed.
But we're past that now. You know, time's passed. Things have changed. You know, we've grown up so much. Don't hurt this man. We got to bring justice to him.
Oh, what's the justice if he just gets away and goes out and does it again?
But he won't get away.
Who's to say he won't get released at some point and go out and kill somebody else's mother? Who's to say he hasn't already killed other people's loved ones?
You just have to have some faith. That's all it is.
I've had faith.
And you of all people.
I had faith in you having my back.
I've got your back.
Don't you play the high card here. You're calling me a thief, but you're about to commit cold-blooded murder. You're not on the high ground.
The thief does interject that he hasn't killed anyone.
Can you then, Maven? How sure are you about this guy?
Pretty confident.
Can you prove it?
No.
How can you have confidence?
No, I'm not allowing this.
How can you have confidence in somebody that grabs something?
Does no one here have my back?
You just called me
a thief.
Does
everyone believe that
no.
this person should continue getting chances? This murderer and thief should continue getting chances, and no one believes me. The person who doesn't care about money, doesn't care about anything except for the greater good of this world, and you can't trust me.
Look, there's
nobody
one
has my back.
There's one question we really need to answer before we can resolve this. Does this guy want to buy some Orky Clean?
Oh my god. Maybe I should be grappling Magpine instead.
Well, you threatened to brand him with it, so that's a definite no.
If he doesn't buy it, I'll give him a free sample, wink wink. Nudge nudge.
I'm not gonna allow this.
Yeah, well, we know both Torgo and my stance on this. Why don't we have some other people chime in? Because he is talking to the whole party.
Yeah.
I think it's very hard to remember the face of someone who killed your mother when you were a child accurately.
You cut out.
Yeah.
Oh, fuck off. Alright, so I think it's very hard to remember the face of someone who killed your parents as a child accurately. And for that one person in a city of, what, 10,000, 15,000? Happened to be the person...
Could be another land.
Yeah, it's very, very coincidental.
I believe it to be fate.
I believe it to be delusional.
Just like the rest of my time with you guys, I'm always delusional, huh?
Digital, you're not giving us any reason to trust you other than just trust me.
What does the drow think?
Well, I just smoked a pair of chickens, I almost smoked some oboe, and then I almost smoked a child. Maybe I'll just put this guy to sleep because I might already get into enough trouble for burning half the city to the ground. I don't know, maybe I should lay low for a while. I mean, I can put him to sleep.
So no one in the party believes me.
Not saying I
don't believe you. It's not about whether we believe you or not. We don't want to kill
this
man.
I have two people saying they think I'm delirious.
I didn't say you're delirious.
I did.
Wait, who are you talking about?
Well, Mr. Orky Clean's an idiot.
Fair enough.
It's not that we don't trust you, but we just need more to go on. We don't have a reason to kill this man. He stole from us, but it's... You know,
yeah,
it's
so
not, it
everybody,
doesn't mean we kill him.
Everybody here but me doesn't have a reason to kill him.
Right.
Too bad the rest of you aren't like my family, like I thought you were.
What, Dan?
I mean, we can have a voting on
it. All right, guilt trips aren't going to work. You still have to prove it.
It's fine. Do what you want. I'll stand down.
This is where I actually kill him.
So you are standing down? Okay, now he still does get his action, and I just checked the opportunity attacks.
On a side note, away from character, I wanted to know this greatly affects everybody's fucking position with me.
Oh, that's okay.
And I no longer care for their safety.
Okay.
That's fine.
David, are you taking this personally?
Opportunity attacks get only one
play.
Melee attack, for the record.
No, I'm not taking it personally.
Okay, I just wanted to
no,
make
that
sure.
No, that would be ridiculous. I'm angry at Dungeons and Dragons.
I think it is fucking crazy that no one stepped up and fucking had my back, but yeah, I mean...
Difficult. You're making it as difficult as possible for people to
do
that.
Yeah, like, this is a random thief, and that's a huge leap in logic, dude. I mean...
I know.
Yeah.
And you're also not really giving us anything to work with other than, trust me.
I think he's...
Yeah, you know? But... As my the reason why I'm doing that is because as my character has been through this whole thing, I've been nothing but truthful, faithful, fucking, I've done every, like, I've given up all my gold, like, there's no reason for me to lie about something like this.
I mean, you might as well have said he's part of the Illuminati.
You've also proven yourself to be impulsive with that trap, the magical trap with the mimic, after
David,
mimics, but...
Talking in character, why don't we question him? And if it... if he admits to, if he at all slips up, we can progress from there.
He did respond and interject that he didn't kill anyone.
I know, so...
Whether you want to believe that or not.
How did he get so highly leveled as a gladiator, then?
Hold up one second here. I do have a use of Zone of Truth.
Ooh, good idea.
That would be good.
So I'm going to...
See, let's get to the bottom of this.
I'm gonna drop.
Slow the hell down.
So let me look up Zone of Truth here. I don't know how
that spell
actually works.
And Zone of Truth. I have that written down, actually. Oh, shit, what I hit.
If he did end up murdering, if he is the guy you claim him to be, then I'll shoot him myself. Or just let you, if you'd prefer.
I tell him, okay, Maven, let's, giving you a little bit of benefit of the doubt, we can... Let's do this.
This would have been a lot easier while he was under a silver net.
It really would have. All right. So that's the path you guys are going to go?
I like that he was given the chance to stand up because Maven played his character better.
It was definitely a good way to go. So
yeah.
I'll take this moment. I think this is resolved, so we'll go back to combat until he's subdued again. He is attacking Maven right now. Does 22 hit you, Maven?
Yeah, what happened? I'm getting attacked?
He's continuing the attack.
Oh, no, he's dead.
That whole RP moment was basically when everybody was skipping their turns.
Oh,
so,
okay.
I mean, yeah, so basically you've come to whatever conclusion you have.
So I skipped my turn by force?
But it's still, you know, excitement's still happening. He has to be resubdued, as I said earlier.
Okay.
So what's your AC?
That's me.
Right.
And for the record, I'll just throw out there in character, if you decide to retaliate again, I won't have any objections to that since he's attacking you again.
Oh yeah, no, now I'm gonna murder this fucker.
Well, no, it's basically you guys are talking through, swords are swinging this entire time, and this...
It's kind of funny that he would attack me and everybody in the party said, don't kill him. I'm the only person that wanted to kill him. Everybody's like,
he's attacking you because you tried to kill him after he surrendered.
Oh, dear.
He's fighting back because he tried to kill him after he surrendered.
Yeah.
Yeah, I think he's swinging swords while we're bitching at each other.
Basically, yes. That's how it works out. He's swinging swords while you guys are talking.
Not taking a chance to see how this shakes out.
I could have put him to sleep.
Yeah, it's not like he stopped... Went and sat in the corner, waited for you guys to take your thing, and then got back up and walked back over to you.
Well, that would have been the smart play because there's a bunch of us and one of him, and he's already bleeding.
Well, he could have ran. He also could have ran away.
But attacks of opportunity from everyone.
Yeah. Well, not if you full disengaged.
We would have noticed him do that and probably stop.
Wait, he hit me all three of those times?
Yeah, that's what he rolled. So here's the first one.
And one of them's a crit.
Yep. So you take 8 damage off the first hit.
Okay.
The second one is a critical on a piercing. Double damage and the target is fatigued.
Okay.
What does fatigue do?
I'm gonna laugh if I die.
Oh no!
Yeah, it's like, okay, I'll stand down. Then you get pierced through the heart. That would be pretty funny.
It would be everybody else's fault.
I don't know about that.
Not really. You brought this one on yourself, dude.
If I would have known that me being involved in the discussion would have taken off my turn, I probably would have done something else.
Well, I asked you if you wanted to stop or not. All right. There's no Wait, there's no fatigued? All right, we got blinded, charmed, deafened, frightened, grappled, incapacitated, invisible, paralyzed, petrified, poisoned, prone, restrained, stunned, and unconscious.
Can't run good. Leave it at that.
Hmm.
Half movement speed.
Stunned makes the most sense.
Well, yeah, what's the equivalent of fatigued? All right, stunned. A stunned creature is incapacitated, can't move, and can only speak... can speak only falteringly. A creature automatically fails.
Like fatigue, though.
Yeah, it's just a little weakened.
Yeah, that's a little stunned. Is way
like
more
attack at disadvantage or something would make.
Yeah,
more
attack
sense.
At disadvantage sounds more appropriate. Plus, you know, you were doing all that running. All right, so that's double damage on this roll.
One.
I found
18. And regular damage on the last roll. 10. So that's 8 plus 18.
That's 2 damage.
Yeah. 18 plus 10. 36 points of damage.
Quite a bit.
Total?
Total.
Okay.
Just glad he didn't take 2 rounds of fruit damage.
All right, William of the May. What would you like to do?
So he still looks aggressive and is attacking?
Well, the attack happened while you guys were talking. You've resolved that you're going to stand down, so you actually get to make the first decision on what's going to happen. You can take a shot at him and let somebody else try to calm him down.
Let's try and grapple him to the ground, then.
I have 9 health left.
That's why I'm going to try and grapple him.
Give me, like, a bonus to attacking, you know, I should attack first now because of fruit right. rage.
Fruit rage is not a thing.
Work. All right. You have to have at least 1 free hand, so that means you'll have to drop one of your weapons.
Yeah, drop the hammer.
All right. And you make a strength athletics check, contested by the target's strength athletic check or dexterity acrobatics check.
All right, mine's plus 4.
All right, so you make your athletics check. Holy shit. All right, so you got a 15. Slash R, 1d20, and he will choose his athletics check.
In before it's like plus 10.
It is a plus 10.
Why?
Wow.
Because he's a gladiator?
He's a gladiator?
I'm a ranger.
He's a gladiator. A gladiator would probably beat the shit out of a ranger in hand-to-hand combat.
See about that once Maven's dead.
What would Ellie like to do, Mac?
Can't really do a pounce.
Nope. She'd make a regular bite attack or a regular slash attack.
She's just going to disengage.
Okay.
Move back.
Is this where I fire another barrage of missiles?
Suzu's turn first.
Oh, Jesus Christ.
I tried.
How's this guy's health looking?
He's
like half? It's somewhere around half. Actually, it might be a little...
Jesus.
Buff me up. I'm going to shred him.
What about just, like, pulling Maven and just, like, tossing him to, like, my side or just, like, pulling him back? Like, that's what I would like to do. Is just
move
on
Maven?
Yeah. Maven just got hit again. He's part of our party. I think that kind of QEDs this.
He only attacked because he was attacked while surrendering.
Hey, Zion, maybe just skip your turn.
Let's see.
I mean, it's basically just as good to launch.
It's really poor form to attack someone who surrendered, just FYI.
I'm not attacking him.
I'm just saying that's why he's fighting back.
Did this dude hear the discussion by now, or what?
Yeah, he heard the discussion, so I mean,
so
he's still open to being stopped again.
Oh, okay. Well,
the reason he attacked you was because things kind of happened simultaneously.
Oh, could I, like, persuade him then to stand down?
Absolutely, yes.
Then I would love to do that.
All right,
what is my persuasion? It is, like, a million.
Yeah. Now, he has saving advantage against saving throws against frightening. However, you're not trying to frighten
him. No, I want to be, like, peaceful as hell.
Knock some sense into him.
Yeah. Oh, god damn it.
All right, so he'll make an opposing charisma check.
Well, he's got 18 charisma too, I bet.
Nah, he's got 15 charisma. That's only a plus two.
Ooh.
Oh, he thinks he can take you guys.
Oh, God.
You guys are completely a mess.
All right.
Sucks for him.
Traxio, your turn.
The persuasion check. What sort of action was that?
That would have been your actual action. You still have a move and a reaction and a bonus action if you like.
Well, I don't know if I could use any of those to move Maven.
No, grapple is an actual attack action.
I don't have a whole lot else to do then. I don't think.
Oh, well, that's an action too.
That's my action.
Yeah.
Yeah, I think done then.
So, since we gave him the chance to stand, then he attacked us, mm-hmm. and especially attacked one of us, pretty much tried to backstab that person.
What happened? But yeah, well, okay.
No, that's I'm going to...
It's while you guys were talking, he attacked
it,
the
it happened, though. He attacked us again after we gave him multiple chances to stand down.
Well, no.
No, we didn't.
Maven attacked
him. We knocked him down and put a net on him.
Because he wasn't here yet.
Yeah, we gave him one chance to stand down, and then he got
I'm going to use my sorcery points, and I'm going to cast one magic missile at level 3, one magic missile at level 2. That's 9d4 plus
9.
Sounds about right.
What if you get all ones?
That's
not all ones.
Holy crap.
That's a lot of
nuts.
Plus,
like, Deluxe is straight on full in hell right now.
Yeah, he went in full on Gatling gun mode, like even worse than last time. So they three and
he had that roll
three
ready.
Ones though.
Three and then two above and one above, yeah. How many sorcerer points did that use? Only two for the quicken, wasn't it? But it used up some of your higher slots.
Yeah, I don't have any level 3 spells left.
Yeah, because you used the Fireball and the Pigeons.
Fuck them.
Seeing this, like, massive barrage is the only things I've seen in, like, dire situations, so I see this as Traxiel, like, actually having my back, even though she hasn't really spoken much to the effect. Like, I see this as, like, her coming to my aid. Specifically,
that's good here. So what are you going to do to react on your turn? It's your turn now.
Oh,
you can, unless Traxio wanted to do anything else with a move or a bonus.
Wait, he survived fucking 30 damage. God. All right, I don't really think I have anything.
He must be almost dead if he was at half before, though.
That's my turn.
Looking pretty banged up, that's for sure.
I can't believe that's only 30 damage.
Me seeing Traxiel do that though, because I'm like almost dead, so I am actually delirious now.
Yeah, you can use a full
So I believe Traxiel's like just coming straight to my aid. And me seeing that for the disdain that I have for Traxiel, me seeing that like gives me so much warmth in my heart that I actually want to try to I'm gonna heal myself and then try to persuade him to stop.
Okay.
And give him his opportunity to speak.
Okay.
Because me seeing someone that like I can't stand doing that for me makes me like kind of have a slight change of heart. Plus, I'm almost dead and delirious. So.
All it took was attempted murder.
All right, so roll me a heal.
It's my third level cure wounds, 3d8 plus 4.
Okay. Ooh, good roll.
Wow, so very good roll.
I go up to, what am I at, 9 or 8? I forget. Hold on.
You said 9. Yes, yeah, there's 9 on the
So I go up to 33.
Yeah, if you put your, since you're using the health bar, if you go and press like plus and then 24, that'll actually do the math for you. Pretty great.
Alrighty, and then persuasion, I guess.
Okay.
And I am proficient in it.
Alright, so you are trying to peacekeep him.
2 and 5, yeah.
So trying to make you say, alright.
Trying to tell him to stand down, and I'll give him his opportunity to speak on the terms of my, like, me accusing him of.
Yeah, so you roll 1d20 plus your persuasion and all that.
You could also point out there's an insane drow that could throw some more missiles at him in the near future.
That would be an intimidation. He has advantage on that. Ooh. Doubt it. Nope. Okay, so he, you know, does see that, you know, the person who attacked him while he was surrendered is standing down, has been convinced by everyone that you're going to stand down, and he stands down as well.
So am I casting Zone of Truth now?
Well, it's Damien's turn.
Okay.
Damien, what would you like to do?
Well, the way this is going, I expect a headshot coming up.
Well, I'm going to move over, like, here, so I'm closer, and just hold my action in case he gets aggressive again.
Okay. Tyrone, your turn.
Oh, wait, no. Actually, so I was here. 5, 10, 15, 20, 25. I can walk up to here. Can I use my manacles on him?
Yo, what?
Handcuffs.
They're like handcuffs.
Yeah, handcuffs.
Well, if he's standing down, he should accept it.
Yeah, but he had a net on him before, which I don't know how he got.
Yeah, and then he got attacked again.
Yeah, well, yeah, he was attacked afterwards, though.
See.
If only I would have been there sooner, I could have shocking grasped him.
And then the ogre jumps in and smashes him with a claw.
His metal restraints can bind a small or medium creature. Escape from the manacles requires a DC 20. Breaking them requires a DC 20 strength check. Each set of manacles comes with one key. Without the key, the creature proficient with thieves' tools can pick the lock. There's no rules on attaching them in combat, so he would not let you do it. So I'm going to say no, you can't put your manacles on him.
Okay, then I'll just stay here and hold my action in case he gets aggressive.
Okay. Tyrone, your turn.
Torgo?
Crickets.
I probably had to go somewhere because of the door knocking.
I still can't believe that this dude took all that damage and then all of a sudden Deluxe comes in here and hits him for 30 and he's like, no, I'm still good. It's like, before he's like, he's in a bloody pool.
Well, he's still in a kind of bloody. He's bleeding all over, but he can still take you.
He's in a bloody pool, takes 30 damage.
It sounded a lot worse when we were describing him being prone and covered in a net.
Wait, do this math.
Really surrendering, he's gonna drop his weapon.
He's definitely yellow bar, that's for sure.
Ooh, even red?
Yeah.
It's about to turn red, so if it would put it that way.
I don't think this is weird.
Well, red to me is like...
How balancing works is...
He's one guy against six.
Yeah, CR, which is challenge rating, is equal to a party of four people, so one of them should be able to handle four of you guys.
I just don't see the sense of making one thief a challenge to the six season adventures to begin with, I guess.
Okay, that's balance back fine.
Find out.
Even, let's look at it this way. You guys are level five, right?
He is so the true gold master. Oh no.
As a challenge rating for level five.
Right, I understand that. I understand the math.
Hit dice.
I understand the math. Yeah. But why bother? Like, why would he... What's the in-universe reason this random thief can hold up against six guys?
Well, he's starting to make higher level and better trained.
Starting to make sense that he'd be a murderer now, wouldn't it?
Well, I can't use mechanics as a justification.
I don't harm flies.
That's an interesting point, Digital, or Maven.
But he's only strong because it's mechanics, not because he actually is justified in game.
Oh my god.
Like,
yeah,
you can't tell.
Max.
He's fighting against six people, yet he's still standing like nothing's.
Hit points aren't an actual thing. It's an arbitrary number to say how long you
can
survive in a
thing.
Fight.
That's all.
This is getting crazy.
That's just how it is, Max.
You're seeing it more as actual numbers when it's supposed to be just a representation of lasting power. So, like, say I'm a level one commoner.
No, I know, but why is he skilled enough? That's what the dissonance is, right?
Oh, well, clearly he's, you know, a big burly guy.
Ooh, so am I. That's one-on-one. Go.
He's burlier. Okay, you want to go? Let's go.
But no, it makes...
What you see is he's a gladiator, which is someone who, like, basically fights...
For a living. Yeah, he knows how to take a punch.
And who knows what his past was before that. and how much experience he has, and all that accounts.
It's like if you're walking down the street and someone picked your pocket, but it turns out it was James Bond.
You're saying, why did he steal from us?
No.
Okay.
Hey.
So I gotta be quick because I gotta go. Okay. So I'm casting Zone of Truth.
Okay. DC on that is what?
It says range 60 feet, duration.
No, what? Minutes. Your 8 plus your casting stat plus your proficiency. What is that? It is a charisma save. I know that much. So he's rolling charisma. It's just a matter of what is your spell save DC? 8 plus what's your casting stat plus what your proficiency. What's your wisdom modifier?
2.
So 2 plus, so that's 5. 8 plus 5 is 13. You don't know the results of this. So he passes the zone of truth, but you don't know that. He does. All right, on a failed save, the creature can't speak a deliberate lie. In the radius, you know whether each creature succeeds or fails in a saving throw. All right, so you know that he saved on the zone of truth, but he is standing down.
Okay, I know that he saved.
Mm-hmm. He's standing down, so it's
he passed the throw.
Passes his turn.
Did he pass the throw, you said?
Yeah, he passed the throw. Torgo knows he passed the throw. He is pacified, though. He's not going to try to escape,
and
so he passes his turn.
And he didn't respond or anything? Or
Torgo, what was the question? What was he asked?
Because that was my action, right?
We're basically out of combat right now until it's reinitiated.
While we're out of combat, I'm just going to move around the side here.
Okay. So what would you guys like to know? He's surrendered. You can put the manacles on him now. Well, until this is resolved, I'm going to say no manacles. But
yeah, he probably wouldn't let me put them on anyways.
Exactly, because, you know, last
tell
time
he him to drop on. His weapons and just...
I simply ask him just flat out, have you murdered anyone?
Ever.
And he'd have to persuade us that he's telling the truth.
Remember, he's a gladiator as well.
Yeah.
So we should get him to drop his weapon before we do this.
Well, I mean, gladiator isn't his profession. It's just an arbitrary stat. So say someone's a scribe. I described someone earlier as being a scribe. His class could be a cleric, for all we know. It's an arbitrary designation that allows feats and traits. So, I mean, he's not necessarily a gladiator. He's just good at fighting. Like, Kane was a weapon master. There's no weapon master class. So that's basically, I basically told you guys out of character that the stats that I'm using are for the gladiator stat. Yes, he is a cutthroat. He's killed people in the past.
But he said he's never killed anyone before, so we caught him in a lie.
You did.
I'd just like to point that out, that now we know he's capable of lying.
Well, I mean, obviously he killed some people.
Yeah.
But he lied, and that's...
I tell him to just drop his weapons, and we'll let the courts figure it out.
I step away and let the party decide what they want to do.
Does he drop his weapons or not?
Yeah, if you're not going to be a threat to him, he drops his weapons. Officially arrested.
All right.
I'd like to... sorry, Mac, I don't want to cut you off. Are you about to...
No, I said, all right, good. He dropped his weapons.
I'd like to question him about his lie. Why did you say you never killed anyone before? A blatant lie.
He says he's not old enough to kill whoever this person's talking about.
How old is he? How old does he look?
Let's see. We'll go...
Wait, what's Maven, a half-elf?
Yeah, their lifespan's
how old's Maven?
A little bit longer than a human.
My mother was a pureblood elf, and my father is a human.
How many years ago was your mother killed?
I have to look at the sheet. Hold on.
About 350.
He's about 31.
I'm not that old. I'm like 26 right now.
Oh, so he was old enough to...
Well, though, how many years ago was your mother killed?
Young.
It's been about 10 years, give or take.
Aww.
When you were 15, you could have been on your own. You didn't need to live with a foster parent.
that doesn't really
depends
change.
On the society that he grows up in. Typically in elves, you're kept
you didn't need to put up with an abusive one at 15.
For the elf, you reach have to like reach 100 before you're considered an adult. But I mean, half elves grow.
Not to mention the fact that you'd have to know about my past and my story before you can make accusations on why I was where I was.
They have an idea how old you are, though.
Well, I would like to ask him then, this cutthroat, where he was 10 years ago, see if we can put two and two together.
Here in the city.
Just here in the city?
He lives here in the city his entire life.
I do find it odd that a human could have killed a half-elf's parent when the half-elf was young. The time doesn't really add up.
Except for the fact that my
was 10 years ago and the guy
I don't know that though apparently so I don't know that
didn't he just state well, that it would happen
I did
10 years
I did
ago?
Explain that my non-biological father abused me and you should already know that my actual father is a human
yeah half elf though
but I don't know my actual father so I just have a description of him.
Logan, can I ask the guy to Well, tell me what you did 10 years ago. What was your profession?
Begging on the streets, like I am now. Making my way as I can.
Can I use insight to try and see if that's the truth?
If he's lying, yes. That is the appropriate one.
Is there anything that we're going to do other than this?
No, this is...
Oh, I can reroll that.
Okay, just in case, because I know Torgo's in
that. Yeah. Torgo, you can go if you need to. He's 100% telling the truth. He's one of these, you know, street rogue thieves. Definitely someone
that's... Everyone inform us that he saved? That his truth thing failed?
Torgo knows, but whether he tells or not... Yeah.
Maven, I don't think this is our guy. I think we should just lock him up and call it a day. I think we just got to put this to rest. This entire day has been just crazy. We're all tired and miserable. You're just absolutely screwed up. I think we just gotta call it here. I don't think we need to pursue this.
Can I use a persuasion roll on him to tell the truth on one question?
You can ask him and then you'll have to roll inspection inside. Insight, okay. Yes.
So no persuasion then?
No.
To like tell the truth?
Correct.
Okay, I want to ask him, does he know of or has he ever spoken to or worked for someone named Valak?
Valak. All right. I think I'm going to have to check your background for that one, buddy.
It's early on the backstory.
Does your backstory say who this fell? Oh, here we go.
Yeah, that explains it.
But does it say who Valak was?
Yeah.
I mean, other than the father. Other than the father, does it say what is, like, Valak's profession was?
Oh, his profession?
Yeah, like...
No, it doesn't.
If this Valak guy is just some regular Joe Schmo, then probably not.
No, he was. Man, I don't want to like kind of meta it now, like yeah, since I didn't write it in. But I just want to say he was higher up in class and stuff when it came to the elves, the pureblood elves, which is why he treated me the way he did for being half. And why he treated
was
my mother the way he treated her for
the elven community you grew up in the city or somewhere else?
I believe it was in the outskirts of the city. I think I wrote it down.
So it's near the city, but not
like not
the city
directly
itself.
In it. Yeah.
Okay. In that case, well, I'm gonna roll a 1d100, and if it's 15 or lower, then yes, he knows. Okay.
All right.
Never heard of him.
Damn, so close. And I can roll insight to see if he's telling the truth.
Correct. So give me an insight roll and we'll see what you believe.
Ooh, I could roll an insight too, probably.
Go for it. Anyone who wants to roll an insight can roll an insight, but I think only Suzu and Maven have reason to.
Yeah, I'm just rolling my eyes.
I get to roll it again.
Oh, is there no limitations on that?
I rolled a 16.
Nope. You roll
I'm
once.
Going to roll because I want to smoke the guy if he's
lying. The target was 15, so yeah, you can tell that he's telling the truth. Because he was telling the truth about being in the city this whole time, whether you decided that you knew that one or not.
So he's never heard of or worked for
them? He's never heard of it.
Okay. Alrighty.
Can we get an apology now?
No.
I don't care about an apology.
You don't even know whether he's telling the truth or not. I'm the only one that knows because I'm the only one that passed
it. Well, you're accepting it. I can see that.
Yeah, Maven, can we call it now?
Oh, yeah.
I don't think any of us need an apology.
I do.
Because Maven didn't.
I just need a reason to fucking kill that guy right now.
Traxio, please.
I kind of want to try out my new sneak attack damage, so I was really.
I kind of want to try out my second rocket barrage.
Well, all right. I'm gonna tell the cutthroat to just drop his weapons, and we're gonna turn him into local authorities.
Can't drop them anymore.
Did he already drop them?
Yeah.
Drop them again.
Oh, okay. Well, then I'm gonna. I would like to
drop them.
I can't pull over any further, sir.
No, then in that case, I'm gonna instruct Damien to put the manacles on him and let's get out of here.
The manly barnacles.
I'm gonna stay right here, so I'm still at range from him, and I'm gonna toss over the man to him.
Yeah, he accepts him at this point since it's all cooled down, and you bring him into the city guards.
Did somebody say cool down? Maybe I should heat it up a bit.
With your Gatling laser. Patchy.
Silly Patchy.
He did it.
Yay!
Ooh, my weapon right. Now.
So, yes. So you get the tools, you go back to the guild.
Alright, can he eat him now?
He's clearly female. And over the next week or so, Cookie ends up forging out one weapon for each of you. It's going to be a plus one weapon of your choice. Deluxe, in your case, since you don't use weapons, you're actually going to get forged an item called the Wand of the War Mage, plus, which is a plus one. It gives you plus one to damage on your
that
spells.
That sounds super badass. Wand of the War
awesome.
Mage.
Yep.
Yeah, dude, what a beast.
Sounds like something he named himself, and we're just like, yeah, whatever.
Exactly.
Let's see.
It's like I'm the War Mage now.
If I made it, I would have been more Magi. I had to actually double check last night.
No, I mean, it sounds like Deluxe made it up himself.
Oh.
I would have probably just called it the Fuck Staff or something like that.
No, not Deluxe, your character, I mean. God damn.
You would have called it the Pew Pew Stick.
Sounds like something your character named. Because I'm also going to name my axe the Axe of the War Mage.
Oh, sorry. Deluxe, I apologize. It's not one an extra damage. While holding this wand, you gain a bonus to spell attack rolls of plus one. In addition, you ignore half cover when making spell attacks.
Yo.
So that means I just get plus one more chance to hit on.
It's plus one to hit.
All right.
And everyone else with the plus
and
one
I
weapons.
And ignores half cover.
Yeah, and ignores half cover, which normally they'd have you'd attack at disadvantage with, but...
All right.
Well, since
we get a badass shield instead of a weapon.
I was gonna ask that, but I guess really what my question was gonna be was since a large amount of time is gonna pass for all of these weapons, do we have to decide now?
No.
Yeah, good point.
You
wish
don't have
Patchy.
To decide right now. I assume it's probably gonna be a maul or a whip for you.
Is there a place to look at this stuff or?
Basically, you take a regular weapon. And it's going to have the plus one modifier, and that gives it a bonus to attack and damage rolls.
Nice.
And the weapon is considered magical. There
presumably
are
one
that,
you use normally.
Yeah. There are enemies who take half damage if you use a normal weapon, but take normal damage if you use a magic weapon against them.
So would it be possible to have a shield?
If you
since, like,
prefer
I'm
one,
using a flame blade. I'm using a flame blade, in other words. So Like it's a magic blade. So would there be a way to get a shield that would buff that hit to hit for that? Or?
No, it'd be plus armor class.
That would probably be two OP anyway.
Yeah, shield a plus one shield.
Torgo, let's get on the armor class arms race.
Yeah, really.
I was gonna ask if I could have like a magical frying pan.
Let's see. Shield. When holding this shield, you have a bonus to AC. Determined by the shield's rarity. This bonus is in addition to the shield's normal bonus AC. So you basically get a plus one to your AC and no magic weapon, but you're cast with the fire, which counts as magic anyway.
I have
so yeah,
small...
you can have plus one, allow plus one shield or armor or weapon.
I use two small weak weapons. Can I get two small weak weapons?
I was thinking about that. Unfortunately, no.
Because that's only half as good for me as it is for someone like Torgo.
Yeah, but your acid doesn't count as a regular weapon, so you can still use that and not worry about the half damage.
Yeah, Max, same
otherwise,
here.
One, two.
But you only do two-handed for your first shot. After that, it's one.
Yeah.
Right, that's true.
Me, it's like every round, it's be half.
So, Logan, how much experience did we get?
You get...
I have no idea at all what my experience is supposed to be anymore. I don't think I updated it last time.
6,700.
6,700, yeah.
I did not.
Just
tell me what I'm at now.
All right, add 3,600.
Which is what?
So what were you at before?
10,500.
Right. You're 10,500?
Is that a level?
I think it should be.
10,000 seems like a level.
That's like level 50% five. Our current experience.
No, we already hit level 5.
No. What I'm saying is level 5 was at 5k. Level 10 would make sense.
Level 6 happens at 14k.
That's not very rare.
Alright, thanks for the session, guys. It was great.
Yeah, alright, have a good one.
Some great role playing.
We're done.
Where's my fried chicken, dudes?
Peace out, Cubskins.
It would be like charred, burnt black chicken, though.
No, I fried them just right because I rolled a natural 20.
Just right, of course.
I threw a little bit of, like, sage on there, too.
Oh, shit, I didn't even grab a card for that natural 20 on the fireball.
Oh, yeah, let's see how bad
turns out, Deluxe killed half the city.
Yeah, really.
You cast a nuclear explosion.
All the pigeons aged 10 years.
The next card for the magic critical hit. It's titled, I Love You, Man.
What?
I can't feel my legs.
Normal damage and target is charmed for 3 rounds.
Whoa, okay.
Behold, the army of burning chicken.
Oh, God. All right. That's all for the stream.